Assalamualaikum and hi to all the lecturers. I am Nadira binti Azan. We present review of diet structure obtained from Australia, Asia and Europe. So for the introduction, tern is a group of birds that inhabit areas of ocean and freshwater area. Tern is under family Sternidae and has 40 species under it. They are roseate tern, common tern, little tern and many more. Tern is a carnivore bird. They eat live fish, crustacean and also insect. And tern is a migratory bird also. So for my review paper, there are two objectives, and the first one is to review similarity in diet structure among species of tern at different geographic region. And the second objective is to review methods to study diet structure of seabird utilized during the last decade. Since I did a review paper, the first step that I use is to point out the keywords that are related, like diet composition, plaster, distribution term at Australia, Asia and Euro, and also the method. And I use all the keywords to search related articles in search engine like Google Scholar, ResearchGate, and also in the ebook and also the website. For the review diet structure, I picked 10 articles for each region, and while for review method study diet structure, I pick article that 2000 and above published. And for the analysis, review of diet structure, number of prey mentioned in article being counted and classified based on family in percentage. So for the first objective about result and discussion, similarity of diet structure then for Australia, Asia and Europe, we can see from this graph, tends for three different locations tends to catch prey from family Cupidae and family Agalidae. So the example of prey that they catch from family Cupidae are sardine and also herring, while the types of prey that they catch from family Agalidae is anchovy. So what are the reasons behind it? Okay, the first one is this kind of prey is high energy content, which is high lipid content. Lipid can store 2 times more energy compared to normal carbohydrate, so it is important for the chick growth. And the second reason is it is suitable for chick digestion ability. Chick is a clumsy during the digestion because they are too young. So eating this high lipid content can easily dissolve in water in chick stomach, and also it has a fewer bones. So for the second objective, which is about the method used to study diet structure of seabird for the past 10 years. So this is the guideline. So from 2010, we can see the researcher used in situ sampling and regurgitation method to study diet structure of seabird. And move forward to 2013 until 2015, the researcher used regurgitation also and add a new one, pellet collection and also digital photo sampling. Move forward to the recent year, like 2018 and also 2019, the researcher began to shift to digital photo sampling. So we can conclude from this timeline, the researcher began to shift from the traditional way to the modern way. So what is a digital photo sampling? Digital photo sampling is a technique of sampling that uses technology like a camera to capture the objective of the study. So basically, the researcher used a high definition camera. So there are many benefits of using this type of sampling, which are the first one is it is non-invasive way. It also can be referred many times. It is capture picture, save human energy and time, and give clear and vivid image. So for the conclusion and recommendation, family Cupidae and family Agalidae are the most chosen type of prey family by tern due to high energy content, which is help in chick survival and suit with the ability of chick digestion. In recent years, researchers start to use technology like digital photo sampling because it is easy to handle. For the recommendation part, diet structure info can be helpful in fishery management, and the method info can be helpful in researcher to find suitable method that suit with it. See my paper. Give a brief summary about the method that has been used for the past 10 years. So this is my references. Thank you.